In this video, I will show you how to add dynamic bone in Unity. Let's get started. Hi everyone, this is Lee. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here, you want to see videos about game development and anything related, consider subscribing and don't forget to turn on the bell, then you won't miss anything. Today, I'm going to show you how to add dynamic bone in Unity step by step using a Unity plugin named Dynamic Bone. If you don't know what dynamic bone is, it applies physics to characters' bone and joints. With simple setup, your character's hair, cloth, and breasts or any part will move realistically. Currently, it is included in the Humble Unity Bundle 2019, which is a great deal from my point of view. If you want to know more about the other great assets in this bundle, you can check my previous video or you can find the link on the right corner. Step 1. We need to import Dynamic Bone from Unity Asset Store. The plugin is very small. Once it is done, you can check the demo. By enable and disable the dynamic bone for different parts of the body, you can see the physics applied to the models get changed automatically. You can also pause the animation and go to the same window. Try to jerk around the model. You can also see the physics impact on the model. Step 2. In order to understand how it works, you can click the player object. Go to the inspector window, you will see the dynamic bone script. That's the script which does the magic. If you'd like to check more details about the parameter, you can simply go to the project folder, open README text file. You will see the steps to set up this dynamic bone and all the details about parameters. But at this stage, we don't need to worry about too much. Let's get back to the player, inspector window. We find the root property and click it. You will see the bone or joint is highlighted in the hierarchy window, which means this bone or joints under this parent will be applied physics. If you want to apply the physics to the different part of the body, all we need to do is add the multiple dynamic bone scripts and choose the right joint as a root. In order to get good results, you might need to adjust the properties like damping, elasticity, stiffness. At the moment, we just leave it as what it is. Step 3. Import your own model. Now let's see if it works for other models. I think it's really good to try it on some animal models. I happen to have this animal package. After importing this asset, we add the elephant into the scene. In order to get a better view, I adjust the camera a little bit. I also disable the animation and make it easier to see the difference. Now let's hit the play button. Okay, the setup is done. Step 4. Find the right joint. Now I like to apply the dynamic bone to the elephant's nose. First of all, I need to find the bone or joint for the nose. Sometimes it is not easy to tell if this is the right bone or joint. We can just simply drag this node and move around. Now we can see the elephant's nose get stretched, which means this is the right one we are looking for. Step 5. Add the dynamic bone script. After adding the script, all we need to do is just set the root property. Now let's hit the play button and drag around the elephant. We can see the physics applied to the nose. Step 6. Add dynamic bone to the other parts. I decide to go a bit further. I just add the physics to the elephant's ears and tail. Simply add multiple dynamic bone scripts and set the root accordingly. Now hit the play button again and move around the elephant. Now we can see the physics applied to the nose, ears and tail. Now we can also enable the animation for the elephant. We can see the physics still works pretty well. In order to see the difference easily in the game window without dragging manually, I simply add the bounce script to the elephant, which will keep the elephant moving up and down. You can see it looks a little bit bumpy. In order to make it look better, we can easily adjust the property, but I think you get the idea already. I also make videos about how to start making games. You can check the link on the right corner. If you like this video, please like, comment and share. If you want to see more videos like this one in future, don't forget to subscribe the channel and turn on the bell. It is really important for me to keep working on the game and videos. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time.